Sorry, y'all. What's up? I'm gonna say something right quick. Now, as I'm making this video, you all probably say that, why did I make the video if I didn't care? But honestly, I really don't care about the negative comments because y'all motivate me to make more videos to stay on the internet. And if I cared, I would delete my channel. I wouldn't talk to any of you. I wouldn't even be on Roblox no more.
Considering that this video is only about 2 minutes long, and about 1 minute of it has audio that has basically broken and crapped out, this is going to be a very short and simple response. I'm hopefully not going to go into a 10-minute rant over 1 minute videos, but it depends. So, you say that had people talking, basically trolls online, you know, making actual hate towards you, if that actually affected you, you would have removed your Roblox account and your games and all that crap by now. And, you know, you haven't done that, but you know what you have removed? You have removed about 5 videos now, each having the same topic in it, changing. First, you'll say that you want negative attention. Then you'll ask why you have negative attention. Then you'll remove that video. You'll post another video asking why you have negative attention. Then you'll post another video talking about how the people who give you negative attention have low self-esteem, even though you asked for it in the first place. And then you remove that video, put up a new video saying that, just like the first one, you don't care about negativity, yet you are always talking about how people are being negative towards you. And you've been saying that people who call you racial slurs and are actually hating on you are giving you headaches and stuff like that. So your story is, you know, it doesn't make any sense. You want negative attention, then you don't want negative attention. And then you're talking, and then you preach, you know, about being anti-bullying, and then go on to say that you want to be bullied. Now, if you were in the real world and you went to an anti-bullying convention or something like that, and the speaker up there said, "I'm against bullying, but I want people to bully me," would you really take that person seriously? Because I sure as hell wouldn't. Because why would they be talking if they want to be bullied? This is about talking. This is about being anti-bullying and not wanting to be bullied, to stop bullying completely. And this person just wants you to bully them, yet they're advocating against, you know, anti-bullying? That it doesn't make any sense.
Well, you know, but I honestly don't care. I'm just making this video just to get my point across, my point of view. I don't care. Just keep commenting, doing stuff all you want. It doesn't bother me because it's words on the internet. If somebody was to say something to me in real life, he still couldn't bring me down because I'm that strong.
So basically, this is just a giant pissing match to see who can take the most hate. Because that's what I'm getting out of this situation. You know, it's not the fact that people are tired of seeing Julius Coles copy game on the front page with titles that mean nothing when it comes to the content that's actually put into the game. It's not about the fact that Julius Coles has made a fan club for a game that he doesn't own. It's not the fact that Julius Coles has recently started taking free models and re-uploading them under his own name as proof that he owns the content so he can meet up with the standards of his video, "I Don't Copy Games," where he says that he deserves, out of all the things that he could have said, he deserves the things that he has right now. And it's not that we don't, you know, it's obviously not that we, you know, hate and don't like him for those. It's because we just want attention out of him and we just want to give him hatred for no reason. That's it. That's, you know, that's totally what we're all about. It's not that we give a damn about what happens on Roblox. It's all about making Julius Coles feel impenetrable when it comes to hatred, and to make us look like we only want attention. It's not the fact that we care. It's the fact that Julius Coles wants to appear as if he is not a, in his own terms, a straight-up pussy. And that's all I'm getting out of this. His YouTube channel, you know, he has a few trailers for Roblox, but that's about it. His YouTube channel is just dedicated to bashing those who disagree with him. And no, it's not even bashing, it's troll baiting, basically. As you've already seen, he likes to bait people into giving him negative attention. He is a troll. And I've already pointed this out about a week in advance when I made that video talking about how he only wants publicity. Because you give him negative attention, and people, see his anti-bullying things, and they think, oh, I'm going to stand up for this guy because he's obviously getting bullied. Now, just because I make these videos, I am giving him attention. But, I don't link to his videos. You can watch his videos on my channel, the deleted ones, all right? The ones that he doesn't even have up on his channel with my commentary over it, all right? And you can see what's wrong with that. So really, I'm not giving him positive attention, I'm giving him negative attention. I'm pointing out to his fans and supporters that the guy you're supporting, if you're using the excuse that he is being bullied, then I'm going to fire back a response saying that he wants this in the first place. And although that's not the best reason to go off of, he still gave the green light to any troll out there who wants to prove that they are a troll to start being a troll on his videos. And then he's going to turn that trolling into an anti-bullying scenario to get more supporters. Basically, publicity. He wants people to think that he's the victim. And I'm tired of people like Julius Coles pulling this bullshit victim card, like all these other people on YouTube, when they're not victims. All right, they're just pretending to be victims. When you look at their past, though, it proves that they're not really a victim, and in fact are using the victim card to get more viewers and subscribers and supporters. And I've been pointing this out for how long now, but I guess people don't obviously care.
I'm a strong guy to keep doing stuff because people.
And that's basically where the video craps out. And I didn't really want to listen to the last parts of this video because I knew that it would have been like his previous videos with a slight change in it. Maybe a different choice of words. But it's just like the first video that he put out where he's like, "You guys aren't getting any attention out of me." So basically, I'm just gonna run this by any supporters who have watched up to this point. Just to give them an idea of how this story makes no fucking sense. He makes a video and he says that he doesn't care about what people say about him, which basically defeats the point of people standing up for him and saying, oh, you guys could make him commit suicide. Well, if he doesn't care, then why would he commit suicide? There would be no reason. But anyway, I'm still going to continue. In the same video, he also says that he's not going to give any attention to people. Yet by making the video talking about them, he is obviously giving them attention. He removes that video, uploads a new video asking why people are giving him negative attention. Now, he basically just asked anybody who saw the previous video to make negative comments towards him. Now, I'm going to assume that not a lot of his supporters watched that video. Because you see a lot of people who dislike him watch the video, and they, some trolls out there seem, oh, okay, yeah, this guy wants it, so let's give it to him. They give him negative attention. He deletes the video of him asking for negative attention, posts a new video talking about why people are giving me a negative attention, and people fall for it as if he is getting lots of negative attention, yet he asks for it. Then, when I point out that there's something wrong with that video, and basically what I just pointed out, he removes it, uploads once again the same fucking video, the same topic, the same reasoning. I point out I have to make another video talking about what's wrong with this. I call it yet again the same video. Once again, he removes it, posts a new video. By the time I can even get around by making an actual response to this, it's already fucking removed. And then he comes out with his low self-esteem video, where he basically says that anybody who goes against him obviously has low self-esteem, yet he asked for this. So anybody who had actually gone after him would have had low self-esteem, but they would have been trolls also. People ignore the fact that they're trolls and basically blame it on the people who disagree with him. And I'm tired of having this reputation of being a stalker and a hater and a cyberbully. It's not affecting me. It's just really pissing me off how people can't do their research when it comes to this. A troll and somebody who disagrees with somebody are completely different. One person does it to get a rise out of somebody. The other person has an actual valid reason to disagree with somebody. But he claims that anybody who disagrees with him obviously fits into the category of just a hater, stalker, cyberbully, ignorant, jealous, hater, wants attention, attention whore, jealous. I've already pointed this out, all right? I can go on forever with these damn excuses. And then he removes that video. Also, I want to point out one of the reasons that he made in his low self-esteem video. His reasoning, for why pe or his way of helping people with low self-esteem was to tell them to go pray to Jesus. All right? Now, I have nothing against people who believe in religion and just in general, all right? But I don't fall for it, all right? I'm not a religious person. But for anybody who has kept up with recent events would know that the church, not a good place to go unless you are gay, atheist, non-religious in general, basically. You are pro-choice, etc. Your chances are getting into the church very fucking slim. So I really hate this argument of you need God in order to have a high self-esteem. As if Julius Coles believing in God obviously makes him higher than anybody else who doesn't believe in it. And the whole concept of having somebody who is higher than you when you have low self-esteem, I honestly doubt makes you feel any fucking better in the long run. So that's what I have to talk about that. So then he removes that low self-esteem video and posts once again this fucking video, where he basically says, you've already seen the video, I want negative attention. So the first video he put out, he should have just fucking left it there, because that's all he needed to do. He didn't need to go on and make five more videos about the same topic with a few changes. He could have left it at the first video. But no, you gotta post it, then get rid of it. Post it, then get rid of it. Post it, get rid of it. And he just keeps fucking doing this. And it's just starting to get really annoying by now. And I don't even know what's going through his fans' head right now. Because, you got the people who are like, oh, I'm totally against bullying, but I'm going to support the guy who wants to be bullied. It just doesn't make any sense in my mind. And it amazes me how 700 people on his channel can fall for this. They're probably just subscribing to him because they feel they're gonna get some special perks for his game. Even though he's basically been shown in the past to make fake VIPs that don't even fucking work and have people getting scammed. So now he's at the point where he has to make free VIP because he doesn't even know how to make a VIP. Which just fucking amazes me because you compare the fact that all I've seen that he's made is a fucking gym. It's not even a gym, it's a black box with free models in it, and he can't even make a VIP correctly, and yet he's able to put out these free model Lamborghinis out of nowhere. Kind of hard to believe that, and I'm surprised that his people who watch him are still falling for this. Anyway, I'm Kosovarchians, thank you for watching.